Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 9. Today I'll be showcasing some basic post-processing steps, including the use of the adjustment brush and radial filter. This is a photo that I originally edited and converted to black and white for submission to Leanne Cole's Monochrome Madness Challenge. A fellow blogger was interested in seeing it in color. So now, a few months later, I thought I would take this on for AB Friday. Well, before I edit, I'm going to crop the photo using the rule of thirds, crop overlay. So I come up to the crop overlay tool and I click on it, and the rule of thirds grid is there. And I want to focus one of the intersection points on the upper eye of the cat. And I want to bring this in pretty far. So let's get this here. And I like that, so I will click done. There we go. Next, I begin by editing tone, which is with exposure and contrast. However, I do like the exposure and existing contrast, so I'm going to move into editing the light and dark tones using the highlights and shadows slider. The highlights will be effective in bringing out more detail in the white fur and the lighter areas. So I'm going to increase that to about there. And the shadows will bring out, opening up the shadows will bring out more detail in the darker area of the file. That's about right. Then when I look at my histogram, I have no data on the far left-hand side. The black slider sets the depth of the blackest levels in the file, and a good rule of thumb is to have just a bit of black clipping. So I'm going to come to the black slider, and I'm going to slide this down, and you will see, as I slide this down, this highlighted area in blue is where there is some shadow clipping going on. And because there's not that much detail there, I'm not too concerned, but I will back it off a bit because it is part of the cat's lovely tail. So there, we'll leave it there. The next thing that I typically do is I adjust the temperature, the white balance. There's an as shot. Or you can come into these auto color settings, and I can choose auto to see what Lightroom will do. So I click on that. I'm very happy with how it was shot, so I'm going to change it back to as shot. You can also adjust these sliders separately if you wish to get customized white balance. Now I'm going to come into the clarity, and the clarity is a micro contrast adjustment. It enhances the fine detail in a picture, and a good starting point is 15 to 20. I may not take it as high. It just gives a little bit of boost. I think I'm going to leave it there. And clarity does affect contrast. You'll see as I increase the clarity, some shadow clipping comes back into the file. I'll back that off just a little bit. Next, I'm going to deal with the color, and I want to make it a little less intense. And I'm going to do that using the vibrance slider that targets less saturated colors and adjust them more than the saturated ones. I'm going to bring this down. It's about there. The next thing that I will do is I move into the detail panel and I apply some sharpening. Sharpening also applies gentle contrast, and I have some presets. Lightroom has presets that are built into the menus for faces and scenic. I have my own user preset, and I'm going to click that here. Just brings a little bit more punch, a little bit more sharpness. Now, at this point, I could be done, but I want to add some more focus just on the cat. And so I'm going to do this using selective editing tools. And I will begin by using the adjustment brush, and I will paint on a mask over the cat, and then I will apply some separate adjustments just to the cat, leaving the rest of the picture alone. So to do that, I'm going to come back here to the Basics panel, and I'm going to click on the adjustment brush, or you can also hit K on your keyboard. And to activate the brush, I simply bring my cursor over into the photo area, and you'll see the crosshair. And the circle around the crosshair indicates the size of the brush. And to change that, I just scroll back and forth on my scroll wheel on my mouse. And because this is a big area, I will make it large. I also need to come down here to show selected mask overlay, and I will click that. What that does is, as I paint, it will show where I have. And as you paint, you need to hold the mouse down, the left-hand side of your mouse down, and it will paint. As I get into smaller areas, I can change the size. Again, scrolling with the wheel on my mouse. I'm not doing this as carefully as I would normally, just for time. And if I happen to paint over an area that I don't want to, I'll show you. Say I come down here, oops, I hit the Alt key, and that changes the cursor, the crosshair, into the erase tool. Holding down the Alt key, I erase, and when I let the Alt key go, it turns back into the brush. Now, once I'm done painting on the mask, I'm going to, oops, I did it again. I'm going to come down here to the select mask, show select mask overlay. I'm going to uncheck it. Now, at this point, I can load whatever effects that I want into the brush, and you will be able to see the change in just the cats. Now I want to increase the exposure on the cat, so I'm going to come over to the scrub slider. I'm going to increase it just a bump. The contrast, again, I want to give it just a little bit of a push, so I'm going to bring that up to about 20 as well. And then highlights, I want to increase the highlights to bring out more detail in the white fur. So let's give this about here. And I like that. Now I can come down and click done, and that will shut out the adjustment brush. Now another thing that I would like to do is I want to highlight the cat's face a bit more. And because it's round in shape, I'm going to use the radial filter. That creates a geometric overlay that will define the boundaries of the changes that I wish to make. And as I click on the adjustment or on the radial filter, and I bring the crosshair into the photo, I click on the mouse and I drag. And if I want to keep it as a circle, I hit shift as I drag, and it will keep it as a circle. Whoops. Well, that didn't work. Let's bring this back in. I don't know why it's doing that. And I can move the filter by dragging on the middle point. And I've got it the size that I want it to be around the cat's face. And now I'm going to come up and I am going to increase the highlights just to bring out the face just a little bit more. and I'm going to close out of that. The last thing I would like to do is to decrease the details in the wall. I don't want my eyes to be pulled to the wall. I want them pulled more to the cat. So I'm going to decrease the details in the wall, and I'll apply negative clarity with another adjustment brush to do that. I come back up here to the adjustment brush, and I click on new, and I come over to the wall, and I click, and I activate that. I'm going to increase the slider, the size of the brush. Oops. I'm going to click Show Selected Mask Overlay, and I'm going to begin to paint. Again, I'm doing this rather rapidly. And as I finish, I come back and I unselect the box to show the overlay, and I'm now going to apply the negative clarity with just that portion of the wall. Oh, sorry, that I went to the saturation. Negative clarity, there we go. And it just blurs it. It softens it a little. And you can see the before and the after. And I like that effect too. So I'm going to click Done. The last step is the application of a post-crop vignetting. I also, once again, have presets for that, as does Lightroom. Lightroom has not a very strong vignette. I will start there with a negative 10. And it's not enough of a vignette for me. I really like to pull focus in on the cat. So I'm going to come up to the next strongest, which is a minus 15 in the amount. And then I'm going to try the strongest vignette in the Lightroom presets. And that's 35. And though I brought in a little bit of clipping in the tail, I'm okay with that. If I wasn't, I could bring up the amount just a bit. So that's it. Here is the finished photo. And we'll go back to the beginning. That was the beginning. This was after the crop. And this is the final. And it certainly does pull more focus in on this lovely little cat. So that's all for this tutorial today. For other post-processing tutorials, visit visualventuring.com and search for After Before Friday. Thanks for watching.